Hello students, myself Anurag Goel from Vidyamandir Classes. In this session we are going to do questions from probability of past year actual advanced JEE from 2013 to 18. Now let's look at the first question. It says it's a 2018 advanced paper. It says there are 5 students S1, S2, S3, S4, S5 in a music class, and for them there are 5 seats R1, R2, R3, R4, R5 arranged in a row, where initially the seat RI is allotted to student SI, but on examination day the 5 students are randomly allotted the 5 seats. Now it says the probability that on the examination day the student S1 gets the previously allotted seat, that is R1, and none of the remaining students get the seat previously allotted to him. What is the probability for that? Let's do it on board. That is, in this question we have student SI, let's say seat RI is allotted to student SI for all I from 1 to 5. But on examination day that seats are allotted randomly, and it says what is the probability that only S1 gets its seats only. That means this will be equal to in how many ways we can allot randomly all the seats to the 5 students, one each. It will be 5 factorial, that is the sample space 120. And over here we have, that is S1 allot R1, and S2, S3, S4, S5 are allotted. S2 is not allotted R2, S3 is not allotted R3, S4 is not allotted R4, and S5 is not allotted R5. That is the number of favorable cases, but that is this clear case of derangement. That is clear case of derangement of objects of 4. Derangement of 4. Hence, derangement of 4 is D4 will be 4 factorial, 1 by 2 factorial minus 1 by 3 factorial plus 1 by 4 factorial, and over here D4 is the number of favorable cases. Now let's compute this. This is 24, 1 by 2 minus 1 by 6 plus 1 by 24. This will be 12 minus 4 plus 1, that is 9. That means the probability, required probability, is 9 by 5 factorial, that is 9 by 120. That is 3 by 40. For the first question, the answer key will be 3 by 40. Let's look at the second part of the question. It is of the same passage that says, now this is, we have for I from 1 to 4, TI denotes the event that student SI and SI plus 1 do not sit adjacent to each other on that examination day. That is, the 4 events are defined, T1, T2, T3, T4. S1 is not adjacent to S2, is event T1. Similarly, T2 will be, S2 is not adjacent to student S2, and so forth till T4. Then what is the probability of the event? T1 intersection T2 intersection T3 intersection T4. Let's do it on board further. It says, that is, TI is denoted an event that student SI is not adjacent to SI plus 1. They are not together. They are not together. SI is not adjacent to SI plus 1. That is, T1 is, S1 is not adjacent to S2. T2 is similarly, S2 is not adjacent to S3. Similarly, S3 is not adjacent to S4. They must be separated. T4 is, S4 is not adjacent to S5. S4 and S5 are also separated. Okay. Now it is clear case of backward counting, because if we can easily find number of ways in which S1 and S2 are together. Similarly, S2 or S3 are together, S3 and S4 together. Or we may say S1, S2 are together, S3 and S4 are together. That is, we need to find number of ways in which S1 and S2 are not together. and all these events. That is, we want probability T1 intersection T2 intersection T3 intersection T4. Now, by De Morgan's law, it will be nothing but probability T1 complement. That is, T1 complement will become complement of this event. That is, S1 and S2 are together. Union T2 complement, union T3 complement, union T4 complement, whole complement. This is using De Morgan's law. Now, that is the, this is the, we are doing this using principle of inclusion exclusion. That is, this will be equal to total, or you may write it as probability of this complementary event will be nothing but 1 minus probability of T1 complement, union T2 complement, union T3 complement, union T4 complement. Now, let's find this probability of T1 complement, union T2 complement, and so on and so forth. Now, we need to find 1 minus probability T1 complement, union T2 complement, union T3 complement, union T4 complement, and this is the what is required. Let's find this probability T1 complement, union T2 complement, union T3 complement, union T4 complement will be nothing but summation of probability of Ti complement, I varying from 1 to 4, minus probability, summation of probabilities of Ti complement intersection Tj complement, where I and j varies from 1 to 4, plus summation of probability Ti complement intersection Tj complement intersection Tk complement, where ijk takes values from 1 to 4, and lastly minus probability T1 complement intersection T2 complement intersection T3 complement intersection T4 complement, using principle of inclusion exclusion, using principle of inclusion exclusion. This is nothing but basic set theory. Let's find one by one what is probability if we have only T1 complement. What is the probability that S1 and S2 are together? What is the probability that S1 and S2 are sitting together, adjacent to each other? That means you have S3, S4 and S5. Now, in how many ways I can arrange them if S1 and S2 are together? It will be one object, 2, 3, 4, 4 factorial into, where S1 and S2 are adjacent to each other. They can be swapped. They can be arranged, that is, in 2 factorial manner. This will be 24 into 2, 48. S1 and S2 are together. Okay. Now, can I say in the similar manner, probability T2 complement will be same, because in that case S2 and S3 are together. Hence, this will be, now number of cases will be 48. Number of cases will be 48, which will be number of cases in which S1 and S2 are together. This will be same as number of cases of T2 complement as well as number of cases of T4 complement. Hence, for this will be, what is the probability of this? This probability will be 4C1 times 948 by 5 factorial, 120. Now, let's compute probability of these. Now, there are, in this case, there are 6 possible cases. Now, let's compute one by one. If we have probability T1, number of cases in which we have T1 complement intersection with T2 complement. T1 complement intersection with T2 complement means, we have S1 and S2 are together, and S2 and S3 are also together. S2 and S3 are also adjacent to each other. S4 and S5 are somewhere here. Now, in how many ways we can arrange them such that S1 and S2 are adjacent to each other, S2 and S3 are adjacent to each other? It will be, let's consider it as one object, second, third. These can be arranged in 3 factorial ways times. In this case, S1 and S2 are adjacent to each other, S2 and S3 are adjacent to each other. But if we reverse them, that is, wherever this complete object goes, in this, there are 2 possible arrangements, S1, S2, S3 and S3, S2, S1. 2 ways. That is 12. In the similar manner, can I say this will be also same as probability if we have T2 complement intersection with T3 complement. That is, S2 and S3 are together, S3 and S4 are together. This will be same as 12. And same as number of ways in which we have T3 complement intersection with T4 complement, 12. This makes 36 cases. Now, let's take another 3 cases, remaining cases. if we have, let me run this, number of cases in which we have T1 complement intersection with T1, T2, T2, T3, T3, T4, T1 complement intersection with T3 complement. Now, in this case, we have S1 and S2 are together according to T1 complement event. T3 complement event is S3 and S4 are together, and S5 is somewhere here. Now, we have in how many ways we can arrange them? This will be one object, second object, third object. These can be arranged in 3 factorial ways. Now, in this one object, we can arrange S1 and S2 in 2 factorial ways, and this 2 factorial ways. This will be 2 factorial into 2 factorial, that is 2 square, 24. Now, let's take the case when it is T1, T3, T4, T2, T4. T2 complement intersection with T4 complement. That means, in this case, S1 is somewhere here, S2 and S3 are together. And it says S4 and S5 are together. On the same lines, this will be again 3 factorial times 2 square, that is 24. And lastly, if we have n of T1 complement intersection with T4 complement, that will be S1 and S2 are together. It says S4 and S5 are together, and S3 is somewhere here. Again, the same case, 3 factorial times 2 square, 24. That means all in, what is the number of ways of total number of ways in second probability, that is probability of Ti intersection Tj, sum of that, it will be 24 into 3, that is 72, and 12 times 3, 12 times 3 plus 24 times 3 divided by 120. And already we have got probability of Ti will be from all, for all i's will be, it was when S1 and S2 are together, S3, S4, S5. It was 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 factorial times 2 divided by 120. So let's find the third case, 3 at a time. That is probability T1 complement intersection T2 complement intersection T3 complement. This makes S1 and S2 are together. It says S2 and S3 are together. It says S3 and S4 are together. S5 is somewhere here. Let's consider it as one object. These two can be arranged in 2 factorial ways. Into these 4 in single object can be arranged in 2 ways, either S1, S2, S3, S4 or S4, S3, S2, S1. That is 4. Similar manner, let's say T1 complement intersection T2 complement intersection T3 complement intersection T4 complement. It will be S1, S2, S3 together, S3, S4 together, S4, S5 together. It will be again 2 factorial into 2, that is 4. Number of ways T1 complement intersection T2 complement intersection T4 complement. It means this will be S1 and S2 are together, S2 and S3 are together. Now, S4 and S5 are together. This makes one object, two object. This will be 2 factorial times. These 3 can be arranged in 2 ways in any permutation, and these 2 can be arranged in 2 ways again. That is 8 ways. And lastly, it is T1, T2, T3, T2, T3, T4, T1, T2, T4. We have T1, T3, T4. Here T4 is missing, here T1 is missing. Here T3 is missing, T4, T1, T3, T2, T4, T1, T3, T2 is missing, T1 complement intersection, T3 complement intersection, T4 complement. That will be S1 and S2 are together, S3 and S4 are together, S4 and S5 are together. That will be again same case as this. This will be 2 factorial into 2 square. That is again 8 ways. Now altogether this will be nothing but sum of Ti complement intersection Tj complement intersection Tk complement will be 4 plus 4, 8, 24. 24 by 120. And the last case over here is if we have all 4 events
complement, that is probability of T1 complement intersection T2 complement intersection T3 complement intersection T4 complement, that will be nothing but S1, S2 together, S2, S3 together, S3, S4 together, and S4, S5 are together. And that is nothing but simply 2 is by 120. That is either S1, S2, S5 or S5, S2, S5, S4, S3, S2, S1. This is 2 by 120. That means probability T1 intersection T2 intersection T3 intersection T4 will be nothing but 1 minus, first we have 24 into 2, 48 into 4. That is 192 by 120. Minus, this will be 36 plus 72, 108 by 120 plus, this is 24 by 120 minus 2 by 120. This is 1 minus 192 minus 108 plus 24 minus 2 divided by 120, that will be 1 minus. This is 216 minus 110, 106, 106 by 120, that will be 60 over here, 53 over here, 60 minus 53 will be 7 by 60, 7 by 60 is the answer, that is C option, that is also the official key. Now, let's come to the next question. It says x and y be two events such that probability of x is given, probability of x conditional y is given, probability of y conditional x is given, and we need to find probability of some events, that is y, x complement and conditional y, x intersection y or x union y. In this question we have probability of x is given, that is 1 by 3, probability of x conditional y is given, that is half, probability of y conditional x is given, that is 2 by 5. We need to find probability of other events, y, probability x complement conditional y, probability x intersection y and probability x union y. It is very simple. Now from this we have probability x intersection y by probability of y is half, and from where we have a y intersection x by probability of x is 2 by 5. Now we have already have probability of x, that means this gives you probability of x intersection y is nothing but 2 by 5 times probability of x, that is 1 by 3. It comes out to be 2 by 15. Probability of x intersection y comes out to be 2 by 15. Now, from probability of x intersection y and this equation, we get probability of y as probability of y will be twice of probability of x intersection y, twice of probability of x intersection y. That will be 4 by 15. Probability of y comes out to be 4 by 15. Now, let's find probability of x complement conditional y. Probability x complement conditional y will be 1 minus probability x conditional y, or you may write it as probability of x complement intersection y by probability of y, which you may compute like this. It is probability of y minus probability of x intersection y by probability of y, or you may write it as probability 1 minus probability of x conditional y. This will be equal to 1 minus probability of x conditional y is half, this will be half, hence it is half, this will be half, and similar manner probability of x union y is nothing but addition law. Probability of x union y will be probability x, that is 1 by 3, probability y, that is 4 by 15 minus probability x intersection y, that comes out to be 2 by 15, that is 15, 5 plus 2, 7 by 15. This comes out to be 7 by 15. It says probability y is 4 by 15, true. A is true. Probability X complement conditional Y is half, that is also true. B, probability X intersection Y is given as 1 by 5 false, it is 2 by 15. C is false. And D says probability X union Y is 2 by 5, that is also false. It comes out to be 7 by 15. That is, answer key is A and B. Official answer key is A and B. Now let's come to the next question. It says three randomly chosen non-negative integers x, y, z are found to be satisfy the equation x plus y plus z is 10. What is the probability that z is even? Okay, it is of non-negative integral solution question. It says there are three non-negative integers x, y, z. They belong to whole numbers. And it says x plus y plus z is given to be equal to 10. What is the probability, given that this, what is the probability that z is even? What is the probability that z is even? Now, we already have an equation like this. If we have x1 plus x2 plus so and so forth plus xr, sum up to n, and it says these are non-negative integers. Xi's are greater than or equal to 0, non-negative integers. Non-negative integers, then we can solve this equation. In number of ways of solving this equation will be number of xi's which satisfies this equation will be n plus r minus 1 c r minus 1. Number of solution of this equation will be n plus r minus 1 c r minus 1. Hence, for this equation, we have 10 plus 3 minus 1 c 3 minus 1, that is 12 c 2. It is the number of solution of this equation that makes x plus y plus z is equal to 10, 12 c 2. Now, 12 c 2 is in this case becomes sample space. Now, for favorable cases, we want z is even. Now, let's make cases when z is even. Let's say if we have z is 0. If we have z is 0, that means this equation boils down to x plus y equals 10. And number of ways of this equation will be 10 plus 2 minus 1, that is 11 c 2 minus 1, that is 1. Number of ways will be 11 c 1. Similarly, if z is 2, it will be 8, x plus y will be 8, hence it will be 9 c 1. If it is 4, it will be 6, that is 7 c 1. This will be 6, you have 7 c 1. Similarly, if it is 6, x plus y will become 4, and using the same result it will be 4 plus 1, 4, 5 c 1, and if it is 8, then x plus y will be 2, hence it is 3 c 1, and lastly if it is 10, x plus y will be equal to 0 and it will be 1 c 1. That is, number of favorable cases over here, this will be this, that is 11 c 1, 9 c 1, 7 c 1, 5 c 1, 3 c 1, and 1 c 1. That is just sum of odd natural number 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9 plus 11 divided by 12 c 2, that is 12 into 11 by 2, that is 66. And this is nothing but 1 2 3 4 5 6 6 square, that is 36 upon 6 into 11. Answer key will be 6 by 11. That is given in option B, and that is the answer key. That is the official answer key, that is B. Now let's come to the next question of advance, that is of 2016. It says a computer producing factory has only two plants, T1 and T2. Plant T1 produces 20% and plant T2 produces 80% of the total computers. Now it says 7% of the computer produced by the factory turn out to be defective. It is known that probability computer turns out to be defective given that it is produced in plant T1. Is 10 times the probability that computer is defective given that it is produced by plant T2. Further, it says a computer produced in a factory is randomly selected and it does not turn out to be defective. What is the probability that it is produced in plant T2? Okay. That means it says there is a factory having two plants T1 and T2. It says plant T1 produces 20%. That is probability that computer is produced by plant T1 will be 20 by 100. Probability computer produced by the factories by plant T2 will be 80 by 100. They are mutually exclusive and exhaustive. Further, it says a randomly selected computer is defective. It will be probability of defective is given to be equal to 7%. Hence, it is 7 by 100. This is given. Now, there is a relation given that says probability that computer turns out to be defective given that it is produced by plant T1, that is defective given that it is produced by plant T1, is 10 times the probability that it is defective given that it is produced by plant T2. Okay, this relation is given. And further, we need to find what is the probability. What is asked is probability that given that the selected computer is non-defective, given that it is non-defective, what is the probability it is produced by plant T2? That is asked. That is asked. Now, let's find probability of defective in terms of defective given that it is T1, defective given that it is T2. Now, it says it's like this is sample space, that is this is, let's say, T1, this is T2, and this is the defective computers, and probability of defective using law of total law of addition will be probability defective given it is produced by plant T1 into probability of plant T1 plus probability defective given that it is produced by plant T2 into probability of plant T2. That means it is D is 7 by 100, probability D 7 by 100. Probability D given T1 is in terms of probability D given T2. Let's assume probability D given T2 is X. Hence, probability D given T1 will be 10x. That means this is 10x times probability T1, that is 20%, 20 by 100. Probability D given T2 is assumed to be x. Probability T2 will be 80 by 100. Now let's solve this equation. 80x plus 200x, 280x is 7. That implies x is 1 by 40. That is probability defective given that it is produced by plant T2 is 1 by 40. Probability D oblique T2, T given T2 is 1 by 40. And similarly, probability D given T1 from the same result is 10 times 1 by 40, that is 1 by 4. We produce these two results. Now, further, we need to find probability T2 given that it is not defective. This is clear the case is the case of reverse probability, that is, first is computer is either by plant T1 or by plant T2. These are two events. Further, this selected computer is either defective or non-defective. Now, over here, the second event result is given. Result of second event is given, that is, it is non-defective. And we need to find what is the probability that it is produced by plant T2. Let's reverse this using Bayes theorem. It will be using reversal law, using Bayes theorem. Bayes theorem, we can say this will be equal to probability D non-defective given that it is T2 times probability T2 divided by probability D complement. This is the probability which is asked, that is T2 oblique given D non-defective. Okay, we have already got all these results. Probability D complement given T2, probability D complement T2, D given T2 is 1 by 40. Hence, this must be 1 minus this. This will be 1 minus. We are using probability A complement given B is 1 minus probability A given B. This is another standard result. This will be 1 minus 1 by 40. That is 39 by 40 times probability T2. That is 80 by 100. Whole divided by probability D complement. This is using the probability D is already given. Probability D was, probability defective is 7 by 100. Hence, probability D complement is 1 minus 7 by 100, that is 93 by 100. 93 by 100, this simplifies to 2 into 39, that is 78 by 93. That will be 26 by
31.
26 by 31, and that is 78 by 93 is even C option. It is not in the lowest form. 78 by 93. That is the answer key for this question. That is official answer key, that is C. Now let's come to the next question. It is of passage type again. It says there are football teams T1 and T2 have to play two games against each other. It is assumed that the outcomes of the two games are independent. That is, whether in first game T1 wins or in second game T1 again wins or T2 wins, it is independent. Further, the probabilities of T1 winning, drawing and losing a game against T2 is are also given, 1 by 2, 1 by 6, 1 by 3. They are also mutually exhaustive. Further, each team gets 3 points for a win, 1 point for a draw and 0 point for a loss in a game. It says further X and Y denote the number of total points scored by each team T1 and T2. We need to find what is the probability that runs scored by team 1 is more than runs scored by team 2. That is, probability X is more than Y, and second case is probability that the runs scored are same by the two teams. This is from 2016 advance. It says there are two teams T1 and T2. Further, it says outcomes of the given is the probability that T1 winning. Let's guess probability that T1 wins against T2 wins. Probability is given to be 1 by 2. It loses against T2 will be 1 by drawing. Probability of drawing is 1 by 6 and losing against T2 is 1 by 3. T1 against T2. T1 against T2. Okay. And winning makes plus 3. And drawing makes plus 1. And losing gives 0 points. 0 points. Further. Now, let's make the cases T1 against T2. T1 against T2. Let's say game 1 result, game 2 result. What are the various possibilities? Can I say we can place these two possibilities? That is, game 1 result will be either win or draw or loss. Game 2 possibility will be T1 against T2 will be either win or draw or loss. That means 3 into 3. There will be 9 such cases. Now let's make the cases when it is win-win. That is, in game 1, T1 wins against T2. And in game 2, T1 again wins against T2. It could be win. Let's say this is draw. Win. Loss. I fixed W over here. I kept changing. That is W, D and L for game 2. Now, what is the second possibility? If it is draw, in first game, T1 draws with T2. And over here, it is win. Second game, it wins. Draw, draw. Draw, loss. Next possibility, loss, win. Loss, draw. And loss, loss. These are the 9 altogether cases. In first case, number of points scored by T1, number of points scored by T2. In first case. Now, in first case, number of score by T1 will be X is, if it is win, it will be plus 3, plus 3, 6. And for T1, and T2 gets 0. It is loss for T2. For win draw, it will be plus 3, plus 1, 4. It will be 0, plus 1, 1. Win loss, plus 3, plus 0, that is 3. Over here, it will be loss, win. That is 0, plus 3, 3. Draw win, 1, plus 3, 4. Over here, it will be 1, plus 0, 1. Draw, 1, plus 1, 2. Draw over here again, 2. Draw loss, this will be 1. This will be, you have draw over here 1 plus win. 1 plus 3, 4. Loss win, that will be loss, that is 0, win, 3. Over here win loss, that is 3 again. Here it will be Loss means 0, draw 1. Lost, that is T2 wins 3 plus 1, 4. And last case is loss, that is T2 wins in both the matches, that is 0 and 6. This is the table, and we need to find what is the probability that X will be more than Y. What is the first question in this passage? First question is probability X is more than Y. X is more than Y in this case. X is more than Y in this case also. Win, draw. X is more than Y in this case also. Draw, win. That means win-win. Probability that T1 wins against T2 in first match, that is 1 by 2. And it is independent game. For second match, it is probability that T2 wins against T2 in second match also, it is 1 by 2. It is 1 by 4 plus win draw, it will be 1 by 2, 1 by 2, 1 by 6, and draw win, that is 1 by 6, 1 by 2. It comes out to be 1 by 4 plus 1 by 12 plus 1 by 12, that is 1 by 6, it will be 12, 3 plus 2, 5 by 12. 5 by 12 is B option. Is B option. And second case, probability you have X is equal to Y. In this case, probability X is equal to Y is the cases we have. This case, win loss. Then we have draw draw. Then we have loss win. And that's it. That is, win loss will be probability of win loss plus probability of draw draw plus probability of loss win. Win loss will be 1 by 2 into 1 by 3 plus draw draw will be 1 by 36, 1 by 6 times 1 by 6, and loss win will be 1 by 3 times 1 by 2. That comes out to be 1 by 6 plus 1 by 36 plus 1 by 6, that is LCM is 36, you have 6 plus 6, 12 plus 1, 13 by 36. 13 by 36, that is your option C. That is the answer key for this paper, this question. That is B and C. For first we have 5 by 12, then for second we have 13 by 36, that is option C. Now it is from 2015 advanced paper, it says the minimum number of times a fair coin needs to be tossed so that the probability of getting at least two heads is at least 0.96. Let's do it on board. Minimum number of times, a coin must be tossed so that the probability of getting at least two heads is 0.96. Okay, now let's consider the case. Let's assume that number of times a coin is tossed is n times. Let's assume coin is tossed n times. Now getting at least two heads will be probability of getting two heads plus probability of getting 3 heads and so forth plus probability of getting n heads. Now that will be equal to 1 minus probability of getting at least 2 heads will be 1 minus probability of getting 0 head plus probability of getting 1 head. That will be 1 minus probability of getting 0 head will be NC0, 1 by 2 to the power 0, 0 heads and all tails, plus using binomial distribution it will be NC1, 1 by 2 to the power 1, 1 by 2 to the power n minus 1. This will be 1 minus n plus 1 by 2 to the power n. I want this to be, in the given question it will be, this is greater than or equal to 0.96. Hence we can say n plus 1 by 2 to the power n is less than or equal to 1 minus 0.96, that is 0.04, that is 4 by 100. That is 1 by 25. Hence we want 25 times n plus 1 is less than or equal to 2 to the power n. and we need to solve this equation for minimum value of n, n as an integer, minimum value of natural number. Now let's take the case when n is 4, it will be 5 times 125, n is 4, it will be 5 times 125, it is 16. Now let's take n is 6, 7, n is 7, n is 6, it will be 7 times 125. 650 added, over here 7, 128, still not, n is 6, it will be 64, then n is 7, it will be 8 into 25, 200, it will be 128, let's say if n is 8, it will be 9 times 125, that is 225, and when n is 8, it will be 256, which is clearly more, and further it will be more, then minimum value of n is 8, minimum value of n is 8. Is integer type, hence answer over here is 8 also, that is the official answer. Okay, now this came in 2015 advanced paper. It is again passage. It says let n1 and n2 be the number of red and black balls respectively in a box, and n3 and n4 be the number of red and black balls respectively in box 2. Further question is, one of the two boxes 1 and 2 are selected at random, and a ball was drawn randomly out of this box. The ball was found to be red. Okay, let's do it on board only. It says there are two boxes, box one. It has n1 red and n2 black balls, box 2. It has n3 red and n4 black balls. Now first question says, in first question of this passage, it says one of the two boxes 1 and 2 are selected at random, either 1 or 2 box is selected at random, and a ball was drawn randomly out of this box, and a ball is drawn. The ball was found to be red. That ball drawn is found to be red. If the probability that this red ball was drawn from box 2 is 1 by 3. If the probability that this red ball is drawn from box 2, that is, given that it is red, it is drawn from box 2, is given to be 1 by 3. Then the correct option with the possible value of n1, n2, n3, n4, n5. n1, n2, n3, n4. Okay. It is reverse. It says instead of giving number of red and black in each of the boxes, it says it is they are variable, that is n1, n2, n3, n4. This probability is already given. In other questions, it is given that n1 and n2, n3 and n4, we need to find this probability. But in the over here, probability is given. We need to predict what are the values of n1, n2, n3, n4 out of the given options. Although there will be infinitely many such permutations, n1, n2, n3, n4. Now let's find this probability. This will be equal to, this is clearly case of again Bayes theorem, reverse probability, because here also we first select one of the boxes, that is one event, first event, let's say selection of one of the boxes, then drawing a ball which is another event, that is either it will come out to be red or it will come out to be black, and given that second event's results, that is result is second event of second result of second event is red, what is the probability that the selected box is second box? This is the case of reverse probability. Hence, let's using Bayes theorem. Let's write this as probability 2 given R will be probability R given 2, given that it is selected from box 2, probability of red, times probability of 2, selection of second box, divided by probability of R. Now, probability of, we use law of total probability, this will be equal to further, probability 2 given R will be probability R given 2 into probability of 2 divided by probability of R will be probability of R given 1, that is, given that it came from box 1 into probability of box 1 plus probability of R given 2 into probability of 2. Okay. Now, it is further given that one of the two boxes are was selected at random. That means probability of selection of box 1 and box 2, probability of selection of box 1 in this question and probability of selection of box 2 is same, that is half. That means you can drop this, probability of 2, probability of 1, probability of 2, they are same, they are half. Now you are left with this. Now given that ball came from box 2, what is the probability it is red? That is n3c1, n3 by n3 plus n4 divided by, this will be, given that ball came from box 1, what is the probability it is red? n1 by n1 plus n2, n1 by n1 plus n2 plus same, that is n3 by n3 plus n4. This is given to be equal to 1 by 3. Probability is already known to you, that is 1 by 3. This is the equation we get from the given data. We need to find n1, n2, n3, n4. Obviously, we cannot find from this single equation, or you may write infinitely many solutions, but from the given option, what we need to predict, what are the values of n1, n2, n3, n4. Now, for making it easy, let's consider n3 by n3 plus n4 as p, n3 by n3 plus n4 as, let's say, p2, and n1 by n1 plus n2 as, let's say, p1. That means we need to find p2 by p1 plus p2. p2 by p1 plus p2 is also given to be equal to 1 by 3. That implies 3 times p2 is equal to p1 plus p2. 3 times p2 is equal to p1 plus p2, and that is, again, that is p1 is equal to 2p2. p1 is equal to 2p2. That means this equation is equivalent to saying this probability is twice of this probability. Twice of this probability, that you can check easily from A option. From A option, it says n1 is 3, n2 is 3, n3 is 5, n4 is 15. Hence p1 will be n1 plus n1 by n1 plus n2, that is 3 by 6, that is 1 by 2. p2 will be n3 by n3 plus n4, that is 5 by 20, 1 by 4. And clearly p1 is twice of p2. This satisfies. Similarly for b, we have n1 as 3, n1 as 3, n2 is 6, n3 over here is 10, n4 is 50. p1 will be 3 by 9, that is 1 by 3. p2 will be 10 by 60, that is 1 by 6. Clearly, again, this will be twice of this. This is also the answer. We need to just check p1 is twice of p2 or not. This condition is equivalent to p1 is twice of p2, where we have taken this as p1, this as p2. C is n1 is 8. N2 is 6, N3 is 5, N4 is 20. Over here, P comes out to be 8 by 14. 8 by 14, that is 4 by 7. P2 will be 5 by 25, is 1 by 5. Clearly, this is not the answer. P1 is not twice P2. And lastly, D says N1 is 6, N2 is 12, N3 is 5, N4 is 20. P1 will be 6 by 18, that is 1 by 3, and P2 will be 5 by 25, that is again 1 by 5. Again, not the answer. Answer key is A and B for the first question. For the first question, answer key is A and B. Second part of this question, this passage, it says a ball is drawn at random from box 1. A ball is drawn at random from box 1 and transferred to box 2. Okay. A ball is drawn from here and transferred to here. Okay. Now, if the probability of drawing a red ball from box 1 after this transfer, now another ball is drawn, and that is probability of drawing second ball as red. This is, let's say, first ball, this is second ball. Probability of second red is given to be 1 by 3. you need to find again what are the possible values of n1, n2. What are the possible values what n1 and n2 can take. Now, as the first ball drawn from box 1 is transferred to box 2, it doesn't matter whether it is transferred to box 2 or not, because this is another ball is not drawn from box 2. We can just say a ball is drawn from box 1 and kept aside, and we need to find probability that the second drawn ball is red. Okay. Now, let's make the cases. If we have probability of finding second ball to be red, we need to make a case that what is the first ball drawn. Now, let's consider that ball to be red also. First drawn is red, probability of first red, law of, using law of total probability plus probability that second drawn is red, assumption given that first drawn is black, plus into probability of first drawn is black. This will be the probability of considering second red. Okay, now this is given to be equal to 1 by 3. Now this is what probability that the first, given that first drawn is red, already we have first drawn is red. Let's say first find this. Let's say probability first drawn is red will be n1 by n1 plus n2. Now over here box contain now n1 plus n2 minus 1 balls, n1 plus n2 minus 1 ball, and one less red. That is one drawn is already red, that is remaining number of red balls is n1 minus 1. Plus over here first drawn is, let's say, black, hence total balls remaining will be n1 plus n2 minus 1, and red balls are intact, that is n1 time first drawn is black, it will be n2 by n1 plus n2. Now let's simplify this. It is clearly n1 plus n2 into this, n1 plus n2 into this. Denominator will be n1 plus n2 times n1 plus n2 minus 1, and numerator will be n1 square minus n1. Let's take n1 common, n1 minus 1 plus n2, that is n1 plus n2 minus 1. This factor cancel out, that is this simplifies to n1 by n1 plus n2 only, that is which is equivalent to drawing first ball as red, which is equivalent to drawing first ball as red. That is, it doesn't matter whether first ball drawn is red or black, drawing red ball from it, second ball will be same as drawing first ball as red. Hence, this will be given to be equal to n1 by n1 plus n2 is given to be equal to 1 by 3. That is equivalent to 3n1 is n1 plus n2, and that says n2 is equal to twice of n1. And you need to just check this, whether n2 is twice of n1 in which of the options. N2 is twice of n1 is not in A. B is n2, n1 is 2, n2 is 3. It's again not C. N1 is 10, n2 is 20, true. And D, n1 is 3, n2 is 6, true. C and D are the answers. That is the official answer. 50, this has A and B. Second part has C and D as the answers. Now, it is of Advanced 2014. It says three boys and two girls stand in a queue. The probability that the number of boys ahead of every girl is at least one more than the number of girls ahead of her. Okay. It says there are three boys and two girls standing in a queue, and it says the probability that the number of boys ahead of every girl is at least one more than the number of girls ahead of her. Okay, let's make the queue from here. That is, this is the first, second, third, behind second, fourth, fifth. This is first in a queue, first in queue. Okay, this is first in queue. Now, according to the question, it says number of boys ahead of every girl is at least one more than the number of girls. That means, according to the question, can I say this cannot be girl? This cannot be girl, because if this is a girl, if this position is filled by girl, number of boys ahead of this girl is one more than the number of girls, but there is no boy or girl that is vacuum over here. That means we cannot say number of boys ahead of this girl is one more than number of girls. That means this place cannot be filled by girl. It must be boy. It must be filled by boy. Now, what about this place? This place can be filled by girl because if this is girl, number of boys ahead of this girl is one more than the number of girls, clearly, because number of girls ahead of this girl is zero and number of boys is one, which is one more than number of girls ahead of this. This can be filled by boy also. Now, let's make this case this, and another possibility is, let's say this is boy, this is boy. Now, if this is girl, this place cannot be filled by girl again, because if this is girl, now number of girls ahead of this girl will be one, number of boys ahead of this girl will be one, but it won't, number of boys will be at least one more than the number of girls. This cannot be girls and this must be boy. This must be boy. And under this similar scenario, this can be again, this place can be filled by either a girl, because number of boys ahead of this girl will be two, which is one more than the number of girls, and can be filled by boy also. That means, let's say this makes another two cases. This is boy, girl, boy. This will be either a girl or this will be a boy, hence this will be a girl. Girl, boy, boy, girl, boy. And over here, if two boys are over here, this can be filled by girl or a boy. That means for this case, we have another two cases. If it is girl, then another possibility is two boys over here. This can be filled by boy and two girls over here. Now, if this is the case, that is, this is girl, this must be either a girl or a boy. Two girls, three boys. Over here, it will be either, it cannot be girl. Because if this is girl, number of, this can be girl. Number of boys can be boy also. This is boy. Okay, this case is removed. Now we are discussing this as either this or this. Now this can be boy. This is girl. Number of boys ahead of this girl will be more than number of girls. Similarly over here. And this can be girl or boy. That is, this is girl. This is boy. G, B, B. These are the five cases you can make. And over here, this is boy. These are the five cases according to the given question. And in all together, this can be filled in five factorial ways. If we can arrange all of them, five factorial. And this case will be filled in. This case will be filled in. Whereas this place and this place were filled by girl only. This is two factorial. And these three boys will be arranged in how many ways? 3 factorial. That means this will be 3 factorial times 2 factorial. And there are such 5 cases. 5 times this. This will be the required probability. That means, or you may write this as 5 favorable cases. And total number of cases, that means there are 5 places which must, in of these 5 places, we need to place 3 boys. That can be done in 5C3 ways. That means this is equivalent to 5 by 5C3. This is equivalent to 5. This is the 5 cases, favorable cases under this situation, and total ways is 5C3. This or this is the same, and hence the probability is, this comes out to be 124, and this is 6 into 2, 2 12 by 24, 1 by 2. 1 by 2 is the required probability. Now, if you generalize this, try to generalize this, that is, if there are n minus 1 girls, and if there are n boys. If there are n boys and under the same situation, that is, if one possibility is if there are 3 girls and 4 boys, you try to make, what is the case? If this is the scenario, if there are n boys and n minus 1 girls, the total number of, what is the probability of this situation? If there are n boys and n minus 1 girls, it will be 1 by n plus 1, 2ncn divided by 2n minus 1 cn. If there are n boys and n minus 1 girls, total will be 2n minus 1 cn, and this is the favorable ways, and that will simplify to, this will simplify to 2 upon n plus 1. Try to think of this, how can we get this? 2 by n plus 1 is the general case, that is, if there are 3 boys, 2 girls, that is, n is 3, and this simplifies to 2 by 4, that is 1 by 2, and if we have 4 boys, 3 girls scenario, it will be 2 by 4 plus 1, 5. 2 by 5 will be the probability. Okay, now this is the answer key, that is A. Now this came in 2014. It says box 1 contains 3 cards bearing numbers 1, 2, 3. Box 2 contains 5 cards 1, 2, 5. 3 contains 7 cards, box 3, 1 to 7. A card is drawn from each of the boxes and let xi be the number of card drawn from ith box. What is the probability that x1 plus x2 plus x3 is odd? It says there are box 1, box 2, box 3. Box 1 contains 3 cards, one bearing number 1, 2, 3. Box 2 contains 5 cards bearing number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Box 3 contains 7 cards bearing number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. A card is drawn from box 1, it is noted by x1. A card is drawn from box 2, x2. A card is drawn from box 3 is noted by x3. First part of this passage is probability. What is x1 plus x2 plus x3 is odd. Now clearly let's make the cases. That is, what is the sample space over here? Sample space will be 3c1 times 5c1 times 7c1. That makes 3 into 5 into 7, 105. 105 is the sample space. Now what are the favorable cases? Could be the 3 drawn cards, each of them is odd. Odd. X1, X2, X3, all of them are odd. Or could be this one is odd and these two are even. Now could be even, odd, even, and last case is even, even, odd. Let's evaluate this. In how many ways we can select each of them as odd? That is, there are two odds. That means 2c1 times, there are now 3 odds, 3c1. Over here odds are 1, 3, 5, 7, 4 odds. Odd, even, even, 2 odds. Even will be 5 minus 3, 2. Even over here will be 7 minus 4, 3. Even, odd, even. Even will be 1. Odd. Odd is 3. Even, 1, 2, 3. And even, even, odd will be 1. Even over here is 2. And odd over here is 4. That is 24, 12, 9, and 8. That is 20, 24, 44, and 6, 53. That is required probability is 53 by 105. That is option B. That is the official answer key. Now look at this next question of the same passage. It says, what is the probability that x1, x2, x3 are in AP? What is the probability that x1, x2, x3 are in AP? Second part says, what is the probability that x1, x2, x3 in the same order, x1, x2, x3 follows AP, are in AP? Now what are the various possibilities? And again, as we look at the option, the number of favorable cases in each option is very less. That is 9, 10, 11 or 7. Let's enumerate using brute force only. That is, if we have, let's say common difference is 0. Common difference of 0, that means each of these are same. That means what are the various possibility? It is either 1, 1, 1 or 2, 2, 2 or 3, 3, 3. That is, the favorable triplets are 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 2 or 3, 3, 3. That is 3 ways. That is clearly 3 ways. If D is 1, common difference of 1. Let's select 1 from here, 1. Common difference of 1 means second 2 from box 2 and 3 from box 3. 1, 2, 3. Then we have 2, 3, 4. Then we have 3, 4, 5 as the favorable ways. That is again 3. Let's take D is 2. If D is 2, it will be 1,
3, 5, 2, 4, 6, 3, 5, 7. And if D is 3, it will be 1 plus 3, 4 plus 3, 7.
Hence, we cannot further go, because if D is 4, if we select 1 from here, 1 plus 4 will be 5, and 5 plus 4 will be 9. 9 is not here. Hence, there is no further possible D. Now, one possibility over remains is when D is minus 1. When D is minus 1, common difference is minus 1. Now, if common difference is minus 1, if we select 1 from here, 0 from here, but 0 is not there. If we select 2 from here, 1 from here, 0 from there, it's not possible. D, if D is minus 1, there is only one triplet, that is 3 from here, 2 from here, and 1 from here. This is different from 1, 2, 3. This is clearly different from 1, 2, 3, because over here, 1, 2, 3 is values of x1, x2, x3. And over here, 3, 2, 1 makes value of x1 as 3. And this is different triplet in these 105. Hence, there are now, this is one way, this is, these are three ways, three ways, three ways, and this is also one way. That is 9 plus 2, 11 ways. 11 out of 105. Triplets are in AP. Hence, the answer key for the question is C. Answer key is C. That is the official answer key. Now, next question says, it says four persons independently solve a certain problem correctly with given the probabilities 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 2, 3 by 4, 1 by 4, 4, 1 by 8. Then the probability that the problem is solved correctly by at least one of them is, that is, four persons independently solve a certain problem correctly with probabilities. Probability person 1 solve the problem correctly is 1 by 2. Probability person 2 solve the problem correctly is 3 by 4. Probability person 3 solve the problem correctly is 1 by 4. Probability person 4 solve the problem correctly is 1 by 8. What is the probability that the problem is solved correctly by at least one of them? Solved correctly by at least one of them will be nothing but 1 minus probability. Complementary event of this will be solved incorrectly by all of them. That is, solved correctly by none of them. None of them. At least one complement will be none of them. This will be 1 minus solved correctly by none of them will be, that is P1 complement, that is 1 by 2. And they are solving independently, hence we multiply them. That is 1 by 2 into 1 by 4 times 3 by 4 times 7 by 8. Now this will be, nothing will be cancelled. 3 is 21 by 2 to the power 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 3, 8. 2 to the power 8 is 256. This will be 235 by 256. 235 by 256 is the answer, that is option A. Now, it says of the three independent events E1, E2, E3, the probability that the only E1 occurs is alpha, only E2 occurs is beta, only E3 occurs is gamma, and P is the probability that none of the events E1 or E2 or E3 occurs. And these four probabilities, that is alpha, beta, gamma and P, satisfies two given relations. One is alpha minus 2 beta times P is alpha beta, and another relation is beta minus 3 gamma times P is 2 beta gamma. And further it says that probability lies in the interval, open interval 0 to 1. You need to find what is the probability of occurrence of E1 divided by probability of occurrence of E3. There are three events E1, E2, E3, E1, E2, E3. It says probability that only E1 occurs will be basically this region, only E1 occurs. This will be probability E1 intersection E2 complement, intersection E3 complement. That is even occurs, but not E2, not E3, will be alpha. Similarly, it says probability even complement intersection E2, intersection E3 complement. That is only E2 will be beta. Probability even complement intersection E2 complement intersection E3 is given to be gamma. And further it says probability none of them occurs is even complement intersection E2 complement intersection E3 complement is given to be P. And two relations are given. It says alpha minus 2 beta times P is alpha beta. And beta minus 3 gamma times P is 2 beta gamma. From here we need to find probability even by probability E3. Probability of even occurrence by probability of E3 occurrence. This we need to judge. Now let's assume probability of even, that is probability of this event, let's say is X. Probability of E2 event is let's say Y, and probability of E3 event is let's say Z. It also further says that the three events are independent. This is the very important thing, that is even E2, E3 are independent events. They are independent events. Now, if even E2, E3 are independent, then any combinations of event and their complement, that is even E2 complement, E3 complement, or even E2, E3 complement, all these combinations are also independent. Makes, let's say, these first equation will become probability of even, let's assume that to be X, that is X into probability of E2 complement, that will be 1 by minus 1 minus Y, times probability of E3 complement will be 1 minus Z. Their product must be equal to alpha. This equation reduces to 1 minus X, Y, 1 minus Z is beta. Third equation becomes similarly 1 minus X, 1 minus Y, Z is gamma. And fourth equation becomes 1 minus X, 1 minus Y, 1 minus Z as P. These are four equations and three unknowns, X, Y, Z. Now let's replace them in first result, first relation. First relation says alpha minus 2 beta, that is first equation minus twice of second equation, X 1 minus Y 1 minus Z minus 2 times 1 minus X 1 Y 1 minus Z times P, that is 1 minus product with 1 minus X 1 minus Y 1 minus Z is equal to alpha beta, that is product of these two, that will be X Y 1 minus X 1 minus Y 1 minus Z whole square, 1 minus X 1 minus Y 1 minus Z whole square. That is from these two you get first result. Now clearly we can cancel some factors over here, 1 minus X over here, 1 minus Y over here, 1 minus Z over here. As it is also mentioned that the all the probabilities lies in the open interval 0 to 1, they cannot be 0 or 1. That means X is not 1, neither 0 nor 1. Hence 1 minus X, 1 minus Y, 1 minus Z gets cancelled. Similarly, from here you get 1 minus Z common. Let's take 1 minus Z common from here. You cancel this factor as well, 1 minus Z. Now let's simplify this. That is X minus XY minus 2Y plus 2XY is given to be equal to XY. And that is X minus 2Y plus XY. XY get cancelled. That is X is equal to 2Y. This implies X is equal to 2Y. And from the second equation, let's simplify that second equation as well. From the second equation, we have beta minus 3 gamma times P. Beta minus 3 gamma, it will be 1 minus X, Y, 1 minus Z, beta minus 3 gamma, that is thrice of 1 minus X, 1 minus Y, Z times P, which is 1 minus X, 1 minus Y, 1 minus Z, is given to be equal to twice of beta gamma, twice of the product of these two, that is twice of 1 minus X, twice of YZ into 1 minus X whole square into 1 minus Y, 1 minus Z. Now again, let's cancel 1 minus x, 1 minus y, 1 minus z. From these two, we can take 1 minus x common. And that also cancel with this. Now this simplifies to y minus yz minus 3z plus 3yz is equal to 2yz. And minus yz plus 3yz is 2yz. That cancel from here. And you get y equal to 3z. Y equals 3z. So from these two, we add x as 6z. X as 6z. And x denotes probability of even and z denotes probability of E3 implies probability of even divided by probability of E3 will be 6 only. From here you get probability of even by probability of E2 will be 2, probability of E2 by probability of E3 will be 3. That is the answer key, that is 6, official answer key. Again a passage, it says a box B1 contains 1 white, 3 red, 2 black. Another box B2 contains 2 white, 3 red, 4 black. Third box contains 3 white, 4 red, 5 black. Do it on board only. It says there are three boxes in this question. Box 1 contains 1 white, 3 red, 2 black. Box 2 contains 2 white, 3 red, 4 black. Box 3 contains 3 white, 4 red, 5 black. Now, first part of this question, first part of this passage, it says one ball is drawn from each of the box. One ball is drawn from each of these box. One ball is drawn, one ball is drawn, one ball is drawn from each of these box. Further, it says what is the probability that three balls are of same color? What is the probability that drawn balls are of same color? Same color balls are drawn. This will be equal to probability that, let's assume that the three balls are of white color. Probability of white, white, white plus probability of red, red, red plus probability of black, black, black. Now it will be probability white ball is drawn 1 by 6, probability white ball is drawn 2 by 9, white is drawn 3 by 12, red 3 by 6, 3 by 9. Red is 4 by 12, black each, that is 2 by 6, 4 by 9 and 5 by 12. This will be option, okay, 648. This is, let's take the LCM, 6 into 9 into 12. Numerator will be 6 plus 36 plus 40. That is 76 plus 6. 76 plus 6 will be your 82 by 6 into 9 into 12. Okay, no cancellation. 6 into 9 is 54 into 12. 48. 648. This will be 82 by 648, but not in lowest form. As given as option A. This is given as option A. Second part of this paper is, so this passage is. First part has answer key as A. Second part of this passage is, it says two balls are drawn without replacement from a randomly selected box. Okay, two balls are drawn without replacement from a randomly selected box and one of the balls is white. It says given that one of the ball is white, other ball is red, other ball is red, what is the probability that the two balls are drawn from box 2? Now it is again clearly case of reverse probability, that is first event is, event 1 is selection of the box and event 2 is the drawn balls are of which color, that is given that second result of second event, it asks for what is the probability that second box is drawn. Let's reverse it using Bayes' theorem, using
Bayes' theorem, it will be probability W red given B2 divided by into probability B2 divided by probability W rent. Now, using law of total probability, this will be what? This will be probability W red given B1 into probability B1 plus probability W red WR given B2 into probability B2. And lastly, third possibility is probability WR given B3 into probability B3. And it says the box is selected at random, hence probability B, selection of box 1 is same as probability of selection of box 2 is same as probability of selection of box 3 is 1/3. Hence you can cancel this probability B2, probability B1, probability B2, probability B3. Now what is the probability of this? That is, given that box 2 is selected, what is the probability? A drawn ball is white and red. One is white, one is red. 2C1 into 3C1. 2C1 into 3C1 divided by 9C2 divided by 1 white, 1 red, 1C1, 3C1 by 6C2, 2C1, 3C1 by 9C2, and last one is 3C1 into 4C1 by 12C2. Let's compute one by one. It is 6 by 9C2. This will be 6 by 9 into 8 by 2, 4, 36. 1 by 6. This one is 3 by 6 into 5 by 2, 15. That is 1 by 5. This one is 1 by 6. This one is 12 by 12 into 11 by 2, 2 by 11. That means we have 1 by 6 by 1 by 5 plus 1 by 6 plus 2 by 11. Now that simplifies to 1 by 6 times 5 into 6 into 11 by 66 plus 55 plus 60. That is 55 by 181. 55 by 181 is your option D. That is, first part as answer key as A, and second part as answer key as 55 by 181. That is D, AD, and that is the official answer key. It came in 2013 Advanced Paper 2. Thank you.